want to help out.
So, Robert, I just showed you a clip of Tyson Fury landing a nasty elbow on NGANNOU. Should they have taken a point away, stopped the fight? Because that was on purpose. It's for me.
No damage was caused.
Okay.
Okay. And I don't know if I don't know what the ref would have called, you know, because it happened quick. On the replay, slow motion, you could clearly see that he went in for the elbow. But during the fight, nobody sees that. You know, I'm gonna give you a perfect example. My fighter, David Navarro, we were actually talking about it earlier. David Navarro was in a fight that he was winning. And then, like, right before the bell rang during the fifth round, in a little exchange, you know, he gets hit and gets a big cut, right? So he comes to the corner and he tells me, Robert, that was an elbow. I know it was an elbow. So they let us work. But then when the bell rang, you know, continued bleeding.
Doctor, yeah.
So they called the doctor and it was really the last round. And the doctor said it was too big, so he stopped the fight like a few seconds before the bell rang. So he stopped the fight and we lost by TKO because, you know, he called it a punch, but there was no instant replay. There was none of that. So the ref didn't see the elbow. If you watch it, it was an elbow, you know. But sometimes
can you appeal it? But it's not only kids only lost.
But it's not. But it wasn't on purpose either. It was just one of those punches where you miss and it comes through and yeah, it hit him with the elbow. Or a hook, you throw a hook and it could have.
Yeah,
It could land with elbow, but it's not on purpose. You know, this one was clearly a fucking elbow. You could tell. You know, there's no, you know, boom, you're
well, he
this.
Couldn't hurt him with his punches. He thought maybe he could hurt him with.
You know, it seemed like it clearly was purposely.
So the ref didn't catch it, so there's nothing you could do about it?
No.
Okay, how about this? Fury, obviously, he got his ass kicked, Robert. No question. How long is normal a suspension in boxing when you get dropped and you take a beating? Is it six
Isn't
months?
Isn't he fighting December 23rd with Usyk?
He has a contract, and Usyk wants him to enforce it, but he said in a video he just released that he's going to see you sometime next year.
Oh, I didn't know that. I thought they were still going to fight.
They should still fight. It's
I
in a contract.
He's going to slap him around.
Either way.
45 days at the most for a suspension.
30 days? He didn't get caught or anything.
Nobody's asking the question. I didn't watch the fight, obviously. Was it after he got knocked down that he threw the elbow, or was it before?
It was after. He got dropped in a third round, and the elbow was in a sixth.
Okay, now that obviously could be retaliation
of
for
course.
The taunting.
Yeah.
So it was dirty. It was dirty on his part.
It was. I think it was. I think
Tyson's a dirty fighter. If he's not dirty, he's not effective.
The punch was, you could tell, you know. Now, there's also a lot of people talking about the way he gloves his glove. I think his fist is under, like, you know what? Have you seen that? Where they say, I don't know, because they said the gloves. You know,
yes, I did see that. Yeah, they flop.
So that means that his wrist is actually way under. It's not the glove is not way. His hand is not way into the glove. So that's why the glove moves.
What's the advantage of that?
Well, because that his punches are fucking landing
with no pad.
With no pad, he's not landing like this. He's landing the punches, but it's with a part with this part of the glove. Right here, so it's pretty much no. That's what they say. I can't say
you got to take into account as well. The gloves aren't an extra large glove or large; they're all the same size. And the guy's what, 6'8", 6'5"?
Yeah,
6'9". So his hands are so big. You know what the padding sometimes.
But usually they're all custom at this level. They're custom. Like people make your gloves, right, Robert? Most of the time.
But I think he was like the ones that was, he was wearing.
But they still
green
have
ones.
To be in I the think... same specs, right?
Yeah, but gloves, it's a very gray area. I remember you one time you were at a fight, Maidana. What glove? Some fight you... No, before that, it was Rosado and Triple G, where you said the glove looks weird.
Yeah, but I don't, you know, Rosado's trainer...
He called you
Mikey was the main event. Remember, yeah. Mikey fought Salido.
Yes.
So we're checking the gloves. Two championship fights, so we're right there. And Rosado's trainer, at that time... Was checking out Triple G's gloves and he's like, he was complaining, no, these gloves are not, you know, because Grant, they make them for the fighter, you know, like Mayweather, totally different. That's where I'm gonna go, because I also went in there against Mayweather. So Rosado's gloves, Triple G's gloves were made a little bit different, you know, and Rosado's trainer was complaining about the gloves. They weighed 10 ounces, you know.
Billy was his name.
Was it okay?
Billy with the glasses and
yeah.
Beard.
So we, and he's like, look, Robert, check this out. Grab this glove and feel it, Robert. I felt it, but I told him, bro, I can't say nothing. You know, Mikey, Mikey fighting Salido. I can't say anything about, I can't go and say, okay, look, this glove, it's not my fucking, but that's your job. So they fought, you know, Gabe lost to Triple G. But then when Mayweather fought Maidana, he also wears Grant. And the gloves are made different. So they make them for the fighter, depending on what kind of fighter. When we were in Oxnard and Alex Ariza was working with a few of my fighters, he brought us some Grant and told us, look, these are some gloves that you could have Grant make them for you guys like this. And we're like, no, bro, you know, my fighters wear Everlast. And, you know, if it's MX or Powerlock or whatever, you know, that's whatever my fighters choose. Some of my fighters wear Reyes, but the way that they send them to us, you know, they don't make them the way we want them. You know what I mean? Triple G's gloves, when he fought Rosado, I felt them, were totally different to Mayweather's gloves when Mayweather fought Maidana. They just make them different depending on the fighter, I guess. You know, I'm not gonna say what it was, but I did see the difference.
But for me, Fury's not a big puncher.
No.
He didn't hurt Ngannou once. Maybe one punch land. Look at Ngannou's face. Looks like your face. Huh?
Look at that guy. That guy's
he's big.
Monster. He has the eraser power. That's why I picked him. So that guy, one shot, he can get him. Ngannou. And again, Tyson Fury does put himself in a position to get hit. We saw it with Wilder. All it takes is one big hook.
And Cunningham dropped him too way back when.
There you go.
So
and he was totally out of shape. You can tell that.
But it shouldn't make a difference, even out of shape. You're fighting a guy on a pro debut.
Should have beat him with no. Yeah, should have.
Okay, so back to my question. How long is the suspension? Will he be ready to fight in 7 weeks? He just took an ass beating.
He won. So sometimes when a fighter gets dropped early in the fight and then he still wins, sometimes they don't even put in suspension. I think, if I'm not mistaken, Louis got dropped in the first round in his last fight. But since he won the fight,
he's not suspended.
I asked the dad because we were thinking of, you know, they were offering us a fight for Louis and there was no suspension. So it was a quick flash knockdown. So they'll probably tell him, you know, take 30 days off from a fight or 45.
But they're not going to the gym every day to check if you're not training. Nobody knows. Like, it says,
well,
on paper.
You know why he wants to take the prolonged suspension, because you know he wants to get into shape, because Usyk's going to get in his ass.
And I think he got a concussion in this fight, because the interviews afterwards, his black eyes, face is messed up. I only got hit with one punch behind the head. It wasn't even behind the head.
Well, he got Triple G. The bottom line is that he looked like shit. He didn't look good.
Yeah, he took a Triple G shot to the top of the head.
I don't think fighters that have a concussion should do an interview 4 or 5 days. Do a written statement. But don't do an interview until your head is straight. Because fighters say weird things when they're not on, you know?
It's true, but it's unfortunate because of the name of the game, and everybody wants content, so...
And you have to, or if you don't show up to the press conference, look at him. He loses, he doesn't show up.
They canceled. He won and they canceled the press conference.
They shouldn't have.
They shouldn't have.
It's like last Saturday, Rocha.
Yes.
Rocha, he went from his locker room to go talk to the media.
Wow.
After he lost to Santillan, he still went. Because, you know... You know, he didn't have to.
Yep.
He could have said, I'm going on, but, you know, so it just depends on who you're talking to and who you want to
talk
to.
Like Miguel Cotto, when he would lose, he never went post-fight press conference ever.
Okay, so then I...
So, to me, Fury's body language, when they announced, okay, Ngannou's here, okay, you're Ngannou, you're Fury, they said first card to Ngannou, Fury clapped because he already accepted that he lost. Then they said second card for Fury, Fury was waiting. Third card, Ngannou was ready to wait. And then he left without singing Fury, they just...
Not the first time. He knew. We've seen that shit 100 times.
Oh, in boxing and MMA, bad decisions.
He ate a piece of humble pie that day, you know? I mean, they gave him the win. Obviously, we know why. But, you know, he'll fight another day.
Okay, who wins now? Usyk or Fury?
Usyk's going to get in his ass, but, you know, again, if you have the prolonged suspension, it's going to give him time to work out. If he fights him in December, he's getting his ass kicked.
Yeah, because he'll be in shape for Usyk, so he's still very strong. Very tricky, dirty, I could say, because he'll use his body. That's why I always, you know, said, you know, he's going to be trouble for anybody, because he uses his body. Yeah. He pushes.
Elbows.
Pushes. Now we know that he elbows. You know, so he is a very tricky fighter. If he's in really good shape, he could get away. And I've always said he'll beat Usyk, because just the strength, the he's just so big for Rosie. But the way he looked Saturday, and there's no chance he could beat Usyk.
Okay, let me ask you this, Robert. You've been around boxing since you were 5 years old. If a fighter takes beatings, like Wilder dropped him four times, come five times, and now he got dropped again, does your body become easier to take punishment?
Always.
So maybe it took a lot out of him this fight.
It does. It does take a lot. When you're, how old is he?
Fury must be mid-30s, 34, 35.
Yeah, okay,
so I don't know. I'll look it up.
All that is you know, when you start, when you get dropped a couple times early in your career, you're 18, 20, 21, you it doesn't affect that much. You still continue. But at, you know, at 34, 35.
He's 35.
Okay, 35. And he's getting dropped. You know,
and he does have a healthy lifestyle. He drinks. And he looks like he does.
Okay. Well,
allegedly, he may not do drugs.
He looks like he does a bunch of tacos. That's what he looks like to me.
Yeah, he eats a lot. Yeah. Okay. Well,
Lennox Lewis didn't like the love handles. Because Lennox,
whatever, you know, whatever he does, you know.
But I'm saying he's not like Mayweather. Mayweather doesn't drink, doesn't smoke, doesn't.
He will not perform at 35. He will not perform. That's why
Oh, it's a psyche.
I think it's time, you know, for somebody to beat him. This guy.
And you say he's going to beat Usyk.
Almost beat him.
What about Andy Ruiz? I keep telling Andy, I think you beat.
But yeah, he's not active. He's not also. So Andy's also one that's not active. That I don't know. But
I hope he gets the fight.
No, yeah, that would be
does.
Good.
I hope he does.
Then Usyk and Andy, maybe.
Yeah, hopefully.
No, or Usyk and Joshua.
I think Tyson Fury, 75% of it's mental, too, as a fighter.
Yeah.
You know what? If you don't go in there, you don't feel good. Look, we have a fighter that's training here, Sosa. Fighting in his hometown, he's got his family there, everything's on his mind. The first round he gets dropped three times, and he gets up and fights the rest of the fight. And you know, later I'm talking to him, and obviously, he's looking at his fan base, because after the fight, he had like a third of the crowd was his family.
That's what happened to, what's his name, fighting a Regis Progress. When he fought in his hometown.
A lot of pressure,
He wasn't, he was supposed to destroy that guy. The guy he fought was Soria. He was supposed to, and he couldn't. He had a hard time. He got dropped. You know, he barely won in his hometown. All his family's there. He didn't train as hard. He, you know.
Also, last second replacement, that didn't help.
It happens, you know, where you're fighting in your hometown. You know you're a badass. You know you're a fucking WBC champion. You just destroyed fucking Chon Cepeda. Now you're going home. You know, it's an opponent that you should beat.
That you don't know, not famous.
So you should. So. He didn't train as hard. He's at home with everybody, friends. The whole family's there. So he didn't perform. Just the way it is. This time he'll fucking put up a good fight.
But here's my thing, Robert. For years I've been saying Tyson Fury's not very good. Everybody was arguing with me. You know that.
Well, talent-wise, he's not very good. But he's very
effective.
Good as a heavyweight. He's so big. He's tricky. He uses his strength, holding, pushing, whatever it is. So that makes him good, Ellie. Maybe he's not very talented. I've told you guys. Anthony Joshua is the most talented fighter in the heavyweight division. Anthony Joshua is the most talented one, talent-wise. But there's so many things besides talent that you could pick Usyk over Anthony Joshua when it comes to talent. Because you could also use his strength, his tricks, his dirtiness as a talent. Not just skills. Skills-wise, Anthony Joshua is the most talented fighter in the heavyweight division as right now.
Andy also has a lot of skills. Andy?
Andy has a lot of skills, yeah.
He's been boxing since he's a kid.
But because of his habits, his weight, his all that, maybe all that is also against him. That they don't. Anthony Joshua always ripped, always in shape. Always. So his only thing is, you know, his mind and his heart is what people question. But besides that, he's a fucking complete fighter because he's dedicated. He's disciplined. He's talented. He's big. He fucking, you know, he's got everything. But people question his head and his heart. That's it. Everybody picks Tyson Fury over him when it comes to who the better fighter is. But in reality, talent-wise, Anthony Joshua is better than him.
I think that if Usyk is going to beat Fury, he's got to jump on him early and just get on him for the first four or five rounds and finish him early. That's the
only
way.
You think he knocks him out?
I think he can knock him out.
You think he can knock out Fury?
I think he'll beat him a decision, I think. But I think Anthony Joshua, from Fury's performance, I think Anthony Joshua will knock him out right now.
Well, how many rounds?
I don't know. I'm not, but I think he'll knock him out.
And you coach Josh Ross, so you know him. You know how hard he is.
I know how hard he hits. I know he'll pick the right and boom and hurt him and knock him out. The way he looked.
Yeah, oh, Fury looks so bad, Robert.
That way. If you have Fury, who's in fucking top shape and is gonna fucking fight smart and tricky and use all that, use press conference weigh-ins, everything to fuck with Anthony's head, then maybe that'll change things around. But the way he looked yesterday, Anthony Joshua knocks him out with one punch.
Antonio Mireles and Fury.
The way he looked.
Yes.
That's what I mean. The way he looked. Saturday. That's what I'm telling you.
He has six fights.
Okay, let me tell you. Let me see.
7-0, six knockouts.
Example. Yeah. How many MMA fighters have gone to boxing and they get their ass kicked? And I've said it before, you know, because everybody gives that YouTuber, what's his name?
Jake Paul, Logan Paul, yeah.
A hard time. Well, you got to fight somebody for real. You got to fight somebody for real. Even guys here in the gym have said, oh, well, he's got to fight a real fighter. He's fighting MMA guys. So right away, we're thinking MMA guys are no good in boxing. Oh, well, he's fighting MMA guys. He's fighting MMA guys. And I even told my guys, you fight MMA guys too. Because we use MMA guys to win. We use MMA guys turning pro to get our guys wins. There was only one change that this motherfucker was...
And now the whole MMA world is celebrating, yeah, like they won the Super Bowl, the NBA Finals,
dude,
the World
this
Series.
This fucking dude was so fucking focused and strong and focused on winning that he fucking actually was very close to pulling it out.
His life story is crazy, bro.
I know, I seen it.
He worked as a kid in the mines.
I know, I seen all that shit.
He started fighting. He's 37 years old.
Badass, and he still goes back home and takes care of everybody back home. You know,
he said he wants to be a farmer.
That's badass.
Bottom line, Fury being who he is, you won't ever see that mistake again. You won't see him. I mean,
I don't know if we ever see him again. He may retire. He retired before.
So this guy, Francis.
Yes.
Turning pro. He was just such a big name in MMA and UFC that he was not going to go turn pro against Mireles. You know, because he's looking for Tyson Fury. He's looking for those huge fucking $10 million paydays.
Which aren't Remo.
But if nobody knew who he was and nobody cared about him and he wanted to turn pro and he comes to us and tells us and they tell us there's an MMA guy wanting to turn pro, will you fight him? Will you fight me to this? And yes, I'll say yeah, because we're fighting an MMA guy. They all suck. In the pros.
You ever fought an MMA guy?
No.
In the pros, they all suck. When they want to go to the pros, you know what I mean? That's why you know, go back to Jake Paul. He only had seven or eight fights.
Anderson Silva.
So you got to fucking give him time. All our fighters, their first 10 fights were against Tyron MMA fighters too. That's the difference.
But now he gave hope to all the MMA fighters.
Now he gave hope to all these guys.
And I'm happy to see fighters make money.
Yeah,
don't worry, this is an ugly game. Boxing and MMA is very hard to make
a
dollar.
He's gonna fight somebody big again. Maybe get destroyed. Maybe he'll fight Anthony Joshua. Anthony Joshua will knock him out. He'll fight
Wilder.
He'll knock him out.
Andy.
But he's gonna make Andy will fucking beat him up. But he'll make another $10-15 million. What, so good for him.
NGANNOU mentioned today he wants to fight Wilder in a cage. Do you think Wilder would do that?
No, he shouldn't. In a cage, he'll beat anybody. He'll beat the fuck out of anybody in the cage.
He should fight John Jones in a cage. That's another.
But in boxing, I think all the guys should beat him. Fucking Anthony Joshua will kill him. Wilder will fucking kill him. Andy Ruiz will fuck him up. You know, all those big heavyweights should beat him. Should beat him. You know, it was just Fury that fucking was totally out of shape.
But he couldn't adjust. He couldn't turn it on. And once he got dropped, I think he was out, Robert. That was one. He just got dropped. He was survival mode for the rest of the fight.
Bro, those punches hurt, man. That dude's the strongest dude in MMA. Like I said, he has eraser power. He can take a couple of those shots, even at our weight.
They say he's the biggest puncher in the world, but I think pound for pound, it may be Tank or it may be Wilder. They need to measure their power.
No, Tank is a tactician. He's got a team behind him that they study the fighters, and Tank's going to win every time. He's got a great tactician team. Look what he did to Garcia.
Were you there?
No, I watched the
fight. Were you there, Robert? Tank and Ryan?
I wasn't there.
We're at another fight, I think, that night. But Tank has a good team. They're tacticians.
They're a great team.
He can just, expose all your weaknesses.
So, right now, this has been the craziest year in boxing. We had so many big fights. We had Tank and Ryan. We had Spence and Crawford. We had now NGANNOU and Fury. So this has been, what stood out for you this year? We had Canelo fighting twice this year. Benavidez fighting again against Boo Boo.
This was a great year for boxing. We had so many, all those good fights, man. You know, three cards that broke, fucking made more than $20 million just in the gate.
Yeah.
Did a lot of pay-per-views. That's already huge. Then you still had the fight in Japan where Inoue fired Fulton, which a huge, very good fight, big fight too. So boxing has had great fights.
They have Regis Haney.
I want to see Loma and Haney again.
I want to see Loma and Tank.
That's interesting. Good. I think it's not easy for Tank, Eli. I know you love Tank.
That's a big fight.
I think Loma could probably beat could beat Tank because he's so smart. But Tank's just strong and young and all that. So that's in his favor. But Loma could surprise him, man.
Here's what I want to see next year. Different fight. The Diaz brothers against the Paul brothers in a WWE style wrestling.
All right, that'd be cool. How about if you have a fight, I was thinking, you mentioned Tank and Shakur. Who do you like?
I like Shakur. We fought Shakur. I had another fighter. We fought Shakur, and the kid has gotten better and better. But I think Tank is a tactician. I think Tank will beat him.
Tank's just probably too strong, but Shakur's fucking talented, man.
Yeah, he's bad.
You can't fucking go against him either.
He is good.
Hopefully those fights happen, man.
I hope so. These are all big fights. And listen, this year, unfortunately, Showtime's out.
Yeah.
So we'll see who steps up and what happens. But this has been the busiest year.
I think like what Crawford did, moving out, you know, promoters should know that that's what fighters want, so they should do it. Instead of waiting for their fighters to leave, let's just do it together.
Wins, yep.
And I'll make money. You know what I mean?
Oscar De La Hoya was saying that. Let's work together.
Because if you're waiting for Crawford's contract to finish, for him to be able to go and fight Spence, then you're not giving him a chance. Promoters,
he's 37 now.
Promoters should do it together, and before that happens, let's do it. They should have done this 5 years earlier. So, Shakur versus Tank, they should get together and do it right away, because that's a big fight.
A lot of big fights. That's a huge 100%. Fight. That's
nobody's going to beat Crawford. He's going to retire undefeated.
He wants to fight Canelo. You don't think Canelo beats him?
If he fights Canelo, he will lose.
He's not going to fight Canelo. That's just
You never know.
No. I mean, look, that's a big weight difference.
But he wants it.
If the money's right, it could happen.
I heard a rumor he might fight Berlanga first at 68. Nah. That's what WBO was saying.
No, WBO was saying. No, that's
what happens to him and Berlanga?
That's a lie, Eli. But Berlanga's not very... But he's too big for him, man. Yeah. Berlanga's too fucking big.
All right, tell people about your card. December what?
December 9th in Tijuana, you're going to see Damian Samurai Sosa in action.
Let's go say hi to him really quick. Is he still here?
I'm Ellie Seckback. Ellie Seckback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.